Buon appetito a tutti. I introduce my dress. Basilico, pomodoro, mozzarella e un po' di pepe nero. Basil, tomato, and mozzarella cheese, and a little bit of black pepper. So here we go. Mangiamo. I translate mangiamo. Let's eat. Let's going as soon as possible to the restaurant. But mangiamo is a really funny word. We can divide it in two little words. Mangi, you eat. And amo, I love. You eat, I love. You eat, I love. You eat, I love. You eat, I love. I will try to describe to you an emotional journey through the food. So, I think that we can start with the sounds. What does it mean food in Italy? With the sounds. We are in a market place in the city, Naples City. Just listen to the sounds. This is the funny side of Italians, as you know. We have always something that is not working. It was inside my presentation. We are. So again, we are in Naples, in the marketplace. And all the people try to sell food. And so you are walking into the streets and you are listening.
I show to you what I'm thinking when I see these pictures.
Wow! Wow! And usually in Italy we used to show or we are thinking, oh, che buoni! Oh, sto impazzendo! No, 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 li voglio, il tiramisù, il babà, la torta al cioccolato, ma che c'è? La cassata, le sfogliatelle, ma quelle ricce! E mettiamoci un po' di crostata con la frutta, ma con una gelatina liquida liquida, no, io la preferisco solida! Ho una fame! Il profiterol con la cioccolata. I was thinking, no, you have to start your presentation to have a look through the dictionary, Italian dictionary. B. Bi buffo, bi buffet, bi abbuffata. Buffo, buffet, abbuffata. The meanings are buffo. Funny, curious, extravagant. Buffet. A buffet is a place where you have a really huge table, you have a lot of dishes full of different kind of foods, colors, smelling. This is buffet. Abbuffata. Abbuffata means then when you are starting to walk in this way, that you feel really full, but really full. But really, really, really full. Your stomach is increased and you are happy to see this while you are eating. You are really, really happy. I want to show to you buffo. Buffo is a strange food. In Italy we have this strange shape food. Puntarelle, fiori di zucca, scorpano, carciofo, formaggio con vermi, leeches. I know that you don't understand what I'm saying, but I'm sure that you are looking at some pictures that they look like really strange for you. Scorpano is a fish. I know that it could be something else, but it's a fish. Yes. And buffet. We have in Italy a lot of different kind of buffet. Starter buffet, fishes buffet, fruits buffet, cake buffet. But the most interesting things is that when we have a buffet, we run to go there. We run, we try to take as much as possible all the food that is there. We don't want to miss any one small piece of food. Everything. And we want to be the first, not the second. And we try to fight with the neighbor. We want it soon. So this is assalto al buffet. And then we have abbuffata. I don't know if you ever seen Italians really that they are eating, not in a formal way, but they are eating with friends. They are like this. And like this. And like this. And like this. These are really famous people in Italy. They are showmen, actors, and very important people. And we are not shy to show it. We want to shy that. It's natural for us doing it this way. I want to just have a short description of that, you mean? So this kind of abbuffata means that I introduce my food. You have to open your mouth and then the food is going down and it stops. And you have to feel this huge break of food in here. Stop. And then again, wow, big, big belly. So again, stop. And then again, wow, I'm satisfied. Yes. But nowadays, we want to try to change this weird behavior, if we can say weird behavior, with this fashion spoon style. We are eating by spoon, so we want to try to taste several kinds, hundreds of spoons that contain a small amount of food. So we decided to change our behavior and eating in this way. One spoon. This is not Italian style. And now our journey is going really inside the food. So I want to show to you our physiological way to understand and feel one small amount of food. More than 100 millions of neurons are activated. So on the left you see our tank that is exploding, like, oh yes, there is the food inside. And then papillae, they say, hey, directly through the brain. And what happens in the brain? This. This happens to the brain. Millions and millions of neurons are activated in 1 microsecond from 1 microgram of food. This is what happens.
Micro, pico, nano, meter, inside.
inside a grain of salt. Inside a piece of red onion. And probably you want to travel inside this food. You are starting with a celery.
And AmosLAB organization.
give a good advice. I think that he's a really good artist. Definitely the best advisor that tried to solve all my problems as fast as possible. Susanna, thank you. Thank you, Cecilia, for your face on Facebook that I just say to you every time, every day, the notification that Cecilia said something. Thank you to all of you. Really, thank you. And I think that we are now language eating in a new perspective. Thank you.
I'm very sorry, I had to go away because I had my hard drive with the Rico movie was at home and not here. That's why I was away, but now I ask you...
But you came
first. Ask questions or die. So I hope you can...
Of course.
Because this is a very good introduction to the movie about... to the Rico de Santis, we have the Trattoria Romana and has the bus restaurant, so yeah, free for you.
Do you feel yourself lonely here with the Finns eating here with them?
Lonely?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they are not so big as you.
I think that this is inside of everyone's
house. So you can kind of make process in them also. Or are you slowing down?
No, I think that in every country you can find colors, taste, feelings, you have to catch it. So like that you are really good probably in the forest to catch mushrooms. One small mushrooms like that. So I'm doing the same in Finland. I try to find the best Nutella here. And I found it, so no, not alone.
Have a different view of eating. We have very hasty eaters and lunches taking perhaps 10 to 15 minutes for us. So it's totally different. And I have found it a problem abroad when I meet some other people from other cultures, like Russians, for instance. They are like you, they enjoy eating conversation, being in a good company with friends, and then you take time. And you must learn to set your nice and warm there and stay. Speaking and stay speaking, and perhaps then you start again to eat something, but it takes time, and that's so that's very painful for us, at least for me.
But then you try it.
Yeah, I try, of course.
For 8 hours in an Italian wedding, you had to try it. I hope that now you are really excited to do that.
Do you have a favorite Finnish food?
A lot of them. Gravilohi. Too much. Yes. But probably smoked is really difficult to accept it for me. Smoked food is really taste of forest for me. Too much. But of course, I have a lot of them. I think that the idea is that how you join eating and not what you are eating. So your mood is really, really important on food. And I put all my emotions on food. I am skinny, but this is not a matter. I'm eating well. But I prefer to spend my time there to eating. So eating is inside me, and it defines, as you said, the personality of probably the culture, nationality, or it's a personal identity. Eating is personal.
So what do you think about the Italian food served in the Finnish restaurants? Has it anything to do with Italy or?
Aha, be honest.
Well, to be honest, yeah.
In Italy, we used to cook at home. And the best food that we are eating is at home. So yes, we are going outside at dinner to taste something else, but we like a lot our cooking. We want our cooking all the time, because I like my own. And we are really different in Italy. We have different recipes, different kind of food through all the Italy. Italy is a really heterogeneous land. We have a lot of kind of different food. So I prefer to eat at home. But you are all inviting me, of course. In group, not all together, but we can fix days and you can try my food, of course.
So what about, has McDonald's done anything to Italy?
McDonald's?
Yeah.
To be honest, McDonald's brand, or this kind of shop, they are just in the big city. So they are probably five places in Italy. So we want it extravagant, something crazy. But no, too fat, no, not vegetables, not fruit, no. We use it when we are a teenager. That's all. Just to be rebel with our culture.
Yeah. Ask.
Of course, all of you know Italian food. Yes, I think so. We tried Italian food. At least once. Cecilia, never.
I have.
Okay.
But are you still eating through all this primo piatto, secondo piatto, and the whole stuff?
Yeah, for the Italians, it's really strange to put everything in one dish. So no, we want to be really clear with the food. We have an order because the taste needs to be really clear on the mouth. So we want the first starter, first main, and then we want second, the last one, and then of course fruits and cake and sweets and coffee and liquors and so on. But yes, of course, for me, food means from the beginning to the end, all the time. Buffet, it's a starter.
Okay.
So usually buffet is served in, for example, in this ceremony, in a wedding, and you starting with buffet and it takes 1 hour, and then you start to sit on your table and waiters are coming and serve you on the table, and then you have first, second, and blah blah blah. Around 6-8 hours is taking this ceremony. And we try to change this name of wedding in a ceremony of food instead of wedding. It's just eating. Yes. And some people, they take the same food in the wedding at home, and they want it the day after also, the same ones.
May I really believe that you're happy when you're eating, when you feel your belly fully stuffed? Because here, if you feel toxic, you feel kind of guilty of eating. I think you can perhaps notice that here all the tendencies are eat less, eat more wealthy, and so on. So you don't eat so much that you feel kind of bumping up.
Yeah, but you know, in Italy we have a strategy.
Yeah.
The strategy is that you stop. You stop for half an hour, you dance a little bit, you talk with your friends on the table, and then you restart again. So you have to be really tricky in this sense. You have to be how you have to wait a little bit of digestion, but you can do that for around 8 hours.
Of course, the previous generation of the boss who had very poor conditions here started in the country, and they knew the possibility to go to the field sports, for instance, and there was this proper table. So they took so much, they feel that food, they just made not to eat much before the trip, and then they went to the boat and they ate so much as they could. And I was ashamed of my kid to make the same even this summer, because he was in scout boys' journeys. They need this kind of joy. They eat, for instance, eating like bangkok. They eat so much, and he made it in a different company with kind of civilized persons like me and my friends, and I was so much ashamed.
Let's now remember my presentation, remember what you mentioned, remember our travel. So where we're starting, and then from this physiological to this psychological way inside the food, and try to enjoy the food in another perspective.
Okay, as the final number here today, and the end of the whole language weekend, I have made a documentary film about Ulrich Berisantis with the soul.